Yes, guys, welcome back to another video. Welcome to the George Benson Football Channel. If a big smile on my face is too much for you at this time in the morning on a Sunday, well, then this video is not for you, because this video is about getting excited. It is about understanding that today is the day of many things. Pochettino's first game as Chelsea manager, Chelsea back in action in the Premier League, Chelsea versus Liverpool, Jurgen Klopp's face on the sidelines when we parade Moises Caicedo on the pitch at Stamford Bridge. I believe this is happening today because Chelsea have an agreement with Caicedo. It is now simply a matter of time, a matter of minutes, hours, seconds. We're down to the deadline. We are down to the finale of what has been the most epic transfer saga that I think I can ever remember. We've got a TV in the office. I was here early this morning. We've got everything ready. So make sure you are subscribed to the George Benson Football Channel so that you don't miss the live stream for the watch along tonight for Chelsea and Liverpool. And whilst you're at it, we're about to sign Caicedo. If that isn't a good enough reason to drop a like rating on this video, then I don't bloody know what is. There's a guy drilling downstairs, which is drilling a little hole in my brain, but we are going to rack our brains here and think about what time it's going to be announced, because I think we're at a point now where we know it's done. Fabrizio Romano, understand the agreement between Caicedo and Chelsea is for a contract valid until June 2031. But the contract will also include an option until 2032, one more season. That means 9 years of Moises Caicedo. Caicedo agreed personal terms with Chelsea at the end of May. Clubs working to close the deal now. Telegraph Football through Matt Law. Chelsea are on the brink of sealing the signing of Moises Caicedo in a British record deal worth £115 million. This is absolutely massive. Liverpool have done their best to change Caicedo's mind, but CFC, his preference, and he's been texting several players telling them that he is joining. We have not got the here we go as of right now, and I think that is because Chelsea are going to put on a show here. Chelsea know that Caicedo always wanted this move. We have been working on this deal. Since Liverpool came in, it drew Chelsea's hand. We had to come out with the big guns, Boley, Vedad Egbali, and really negotiate with Brighton. And it looks now, over the course of Saturday night, Chelsea have managed to complete this deal. When I say complete, we mean we actually know what we're paying now. Brighton accept that it's going to happen. And from what I understand, from all that we're seeing, all that we're reading, now that we know about the details of the contract that Caicedo will be signing at Chelsea, we can all pretty much celebrate that this deal is done and it is in Chelsea's favour. We have broken the record, the British record, for signing a player. It's incredible. And now when you look at the midfield, Enzo Fernandez, Moises Caicedo, over 200 million quid's worth of a pivot there. The word pivot has never been so valuable in the history of time. But this is incredible. The fact that Chelsea, after the way that this saga has gone, we have now pretty much effectively got our man. And I needed to get you guys gassed here on Sunday morning, because it's normally the day of rest. But we aren't resting today. We are going full in on GBFC. There might even be another video before kickoff, and then I'm going to try and go live, maybe even for the Brentford Spurs game. We're going to do like a 6-hour stream today. And then, of course, six things we learned straight after the game. Kepa Arrizabalaga is gone, ladies and gentlemen. Simon Johnson says here, CFC expect Kepa to complete loan move to Real Madrid, already looking at options to replace him, but Kasper Schmeichel has been ruled out. Kasper Schmeichel was an interesting one. We'll talk about him a bit more. Sanchez is the new number one regardless. So this deal for Kepa Arrizabalaga to Real Madrid, here we go. Loan deal verbally agreed between Real and Chelsea with no obligation slash permanent move for the Spanish goalkeeper. Kepa immediately said yes to Real after talks with Bayern over the last 3 or 4 days. He already said his goodbyes, ready to travel. This confirms that Kepa will not be in the matchday squad for Chelsea to face Liverpool today. The fact that there is no obligation to be able to buy him, I actually think maybe this is a good thing in a way, because Kepa is now going to be the first choice keeper at Real Madrid. Every single club in world football will be aware of this deal. They'll be able to see him. And if Kepa does well, then it creates the opportunity for a bidding war come the end of this loan when Kepa ends this season. He's going to be playing in the Champions League for Real, La Liga, the biggest club in world football. So at this point now, Chelsea can expect a lot of clubs to come in for Kepa. And I think what this enables us to do is, even though when he comes back, there's only going to be 1 year left on the deal, if Kepa does well at Real Madrid, Real Madrid will probably buy him. And if they don't, everyone's eyes have been on him. He could probably, if he has a good season, be seen as a top goalkeeper in world football. And then, before you know it, Chelsea have got multiple clubs offering a player who's on 190 grand a week, a deal to get out of Chelsea. Kepa, in my opinion, never plays for Chelsea again. It's 190 grand a week off the wage bill, which, when you think about the club trying to do everything that we possibly can to save money, to enable these deals. We're going to talk Lavia in a moment as well, but 115 million, British record for Caicedo. Chelsea have got to do everything in their power to lower that wage bill. And when you think about the old regime, Raheem Sterling is still, well, Lukaku's not gone yet, but Sterling is going to be the only player on those massive wages. We have managed to bring in all of these new players in the last 12, 14 months under a new structure at the club. People are choosing Chelsea over Liverpool. If that isn't a good enough reason to get excited for what this new project under this new ownership means, I don't know what is. We have cleaned out so much dead wood, including Kepa now, because I do think he was categorised, at least in my book, as a bit of dead wood at Chelsea Football Club. I'm excited to see Sanchez today against Liverpool. Massive game for him to make his Chelsea debut. And Kepa going to Real Madrid, I wish him all the best, and I think that he could not have ever got a better move after what I would consider to be an average, if not underwhelming, time at Chelsea Football Club. Many would say he's even upgraded. Of course, I would never say that. I'm sure you would never say that. But in the eyes of the footballing world, potentially he did. Jacob Steinberg's tweet here: Chelsea also considering Kasper Schmeichel after agreeing to loan out Kepa. Conflicting to what we've seen here from Simon Johnson, but Kasper Schmeichel, very good, experienced goalkeeper. He's a lot older. He's got great experience in the Premier League. Fantastic shot stopper as well. So maybe Kasper Schmeichel is a second choice. Is he a bit too old now? Is he done? I don't know. I think it's interesting. If Sanchez is going to be the new number one for this season, it's still a gamble. But if he lives up to the form that we saw of him at Brighton, under, I can't remember the name of the flipping goalkeeping coach now that we stole from Brighton, I think it's Ben Roberts. If he can work with Ben Roberts again, get back to that level of form that made him Brighton's number one in the first place, then Chelsea have done incredibly well here. We get a new keeper in on a long-term deal, significantly lower wages, get rid of Kepa's wage bill, and the calamitous events that tend to unfold once in a while with Kepa Arrizabalaga. Chelsea have done well in this situation. Romeo Lavia, you also want updates on that, don't you? On a Sunday morning. The latest news regarding Romeo Lavia, as I just scroll through here. Southampton manager Russell Martin: Romeo Lavia not playing as he's not in the right frame of mind to play. I also believe it's edging closer to a conclusion. And from what we understand, Liverpool have not yet submitted any kind of bid for Romeo Lavia that is of the mark, the benchmark that Southampton set of 50 million. Chelsea have offered a deal in and around the 55 million pound bracket, which of course Southampton have accepted. It's above their valuation for the player. And with the involvement of Joe Shields at Chelsea with his communication with Romeo Lavia, I think Chelsea could well be about to complete the biggest double transfer heist in history for a midfield pivot. It's incredible. And Romeo Lavia, if he signs, Lavia, Enzo, Santos, Caicedo, there is not better depth in the world, I think, right now. Maybe Real Madrid could argue with that. Chelsea are building something incredibly special here. And I want to finish this video today. We're going to talk about something that I believe has happened at Stamford Bridge. One of my good friends messaged me about this yesterday, saying that Pochettino wants the dugout to not be as you walk out the tunnel on the left. He wants it to be on the right this season, which we might see today against Liverpool. It's the little things in a change when a club has been going through such a horrible time with energy, with results, with everything surrounding the club was just chaos, turmoil. These little changes could make a massive difference. Put Pochettino closer to the Matthew Harding end. When everyone comes out today against Liverpool, new atmosphere, brand new passion, brand new expectation, but also excitement. And I think all of these little changes that we might just see, because also, David Ornstein also said yesterday, Chelsea will put some club staff in with them, Pochettino's staff, to really help build what they hope will be a formidable coaching unit that avoids them having yet another change in the dugout at Stamford Bridge. This can go one of two ways. If the club are adding people to Pochettino's existing team and staff, let's just hope that they all work together really well. If we're trying to add numbers to make things unbreakable, that doesn't always work. Sometimes you've just got to leave it down to the manager and trust in him. But what I can see and what we can hear, Pochettino is doing all the little things he can to try and give Chelsea the best chance to succeed. The owners are investing heavily in this team for the now as well as the future, which was the big sticking point earlier this week when we thought Liverpool had absolutely hijacked this deal. Chelsea are doing bits, and it is our job now as fans to get excited, get behind the team. And today against Liverpool, even if we lose, let's not let all of this cloud over the fact that there is a big buzz around Chelsea right now. I can feel it with your YouTube comments, and I'm sure it's going to translate to the players today and around the club as well. Thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed this Sunday morning Chelsea news episode, please hit the like button. Subscribe if you are new. And if you haven't got them bell notifications on, well, you're going to be missing hours worth of content today. And I mean multiple hours. Come on, you Blues.